Hello and you're welcome to Social Media Trends right here on VNTV, powerhouse of entertainment. We're accessible on www.vnationtv.com. Follow us on all our social media platforms and let's get interactive. And of course, if you want to repost of this story and other entertainment stories VNTV has to offer, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Today is Thursday, Throwback Thursday. So if you have an old picture and all that, I have a friend who used to post childhood pictures of us. Sometimes when you see, you just scream. You are just amazed that these are your childhood pictures or like your old pictures. Sometimes some of us are 4 or 5 years pictures ago. Yeah, terrible to look at. Well, yes, what do we have today? What's trending on social media? Now today we are talking about a man of God who has said something about an artist who is well known in Ghana here. We are talking about Eastwood Annaba. He said he's seeing, you know, Stone Boy as a professor. For a big man of God to say this, why? He said he listened to Stoneboy's song. So after all, Eastwood Annaba listens to Stoneboy's song. So who are you to judge anyone? You know, he listened to the lyrics of the song and he was like, God has blessed Ghana with very intelligent people and Stoneboy is considered as one of them. He said he called his daughter immediately to come and then get Stoneboy's number for him because he just wants to call and say, hello, Stoneboy. You're very intelligent. So yes, that is what Eastwood Annaba has said about Stoneboy. But don't forget that Stoneboy has launched a new name. He said he's no longer Stoneboy, he's Stone God. Stone God. What do you guys think about it? Stoneboy, Stone God. You know, which one works better? But all the same, we are just happy for him. And of course, you know, as usual, we are more interested in what people are saying about it. In the comments, someone says, Stoneboy ran this thing. Wasn't a joke when he said Soul Healer musical dealer. The power in his music is untouchable. Bim. Yeah. And another says, watch. Yes, so we are happy for Stoneboy. And as well, this comment coming from this man of God. Yes, away from that, we all know Ibrahim, the young guy who has got lots of money and is accused of a lot of things, especially when it comes to money laundering. We don't know. He says he's a businessman, so we leave it be that way. He's a businessman. People don't go meddling in somebody's, you know, business and all that. Yes, he's teasing Namwan. They're talking about the owner of Men's Gold. We know that there's just so much brouhaha going on when it comes to, you know, Men's Gold's operation at the moment. A lot of things have been seized and customers are, you know, going there. They want to get their money. Everyone is scared. And as a matter of fact, a lot of politicians and big men have invested into it. Asamoah has invested a lot of money into it. So it's like there's a lot at stake if Men's Gold should collapse at the moment. Now, what is Ibrahim saying? Ibrahim is saying that Namwan has wasted money to sign artists and actors and actresses who, as a matter of fact, having acted in so many years, we know that when he just came, he just had the likes of Jackie Appiah. You guys just know them. Becca, we're talking about Sani Toby's wife, the freshly married couples who are having so much fun somewhere, and their recent video that came out, oosh, love is beautiful and sweet. Yeah, let's leave that be. Benedict Tagafa, a lot of them, Gardner, just so much. And he's saying that the owner of Men's Group has just wasted money signing all these people. They are doing that. Please, let's not forget Shatawale is there, Stoneboy, yeah, of course, we cannot do without them. He's just saying he has wasted so much money to sign them up, and that's why he's in the mess he is today. So as a matter of fact, it looks like, I don't know if he's got beef with him, but it looks like he's just trying to tease him. But anyway, we're just hoping that people will get their money. We don't want so much demonstrations and all that causing traffic. Yeah, so away from that, let's go to Nigeria. What's going on? Wizkid is making waves in his music career. It's like he's at the peak of his music career at the moment. But then he's got issues when it comes to social life. I'm talking about his children, dealing with his children and his baby mamas. What is going on? You guys, those who follow Wizkid very well can remember that he did a post and said the hungry hoes are not getting married, and got the likes of some people from the Big Brother, former Big Brother, you know, the past ones. Some came on board talking and saying that no, you don't have to do that. And Wizkid actually retaliated by saying, you can kill yourself because I said hungry hoes, like hoes, prostitutes are not getting money from me. Now, if you follow Oluwani Shola, it looks like she is a baby mama of Wizkid and has got this beautiful boy with Wizkid, of which she says she had to go through a lot of trauma in order to even prove that the child is Wizkid. She had to go through DNA and all that till Wizkid accepted the child. Now, she has come out to if you go to her page, it's like she has written a whole novel to narrate everything that happened, the way she met Wizkid and what ensued between them and all that. She's just feeling offended to have been be part of that whole hoes are not getting money from me. And if you go to her page, she's just posted just so many things. Yes. And she said that she had to do a lot of sacrifices for Wizkid. Because of Wizkid, she had to postpone her NYSC. By then she was pregnant, like 20s, you know. That was like quite an early stage for her. But then if you look at her recently posted stuff on Instagram, you see that she has posted something that happens to be like it's between her and her baby daddy. You know, we're talking about Wizkid. And you can see he said, "Hi, how are you? How are you doing? I always show the pictures of him. LOL. It's almost as if he knows him. Now, you know, it's like he's just trying to get his children together and get the children acquainted to each other, for the children to get to know themselves." And she seemed to be pretty cool about it and doesn't really have issues, because if you look at, we're projecting what she said, but you see it on the screen. At some point he said, "Hey, how are you? I hate to have had to reach out to you out on here, but figured it was the best way to get directly in touch. Would love for the boys to get to know each other and for Zion to have a relationship with his elder brother. Family is more important." Yes, family is more important, but it is not good for you to discriminate and you know, have preferences when it comes to your children. You prefer one over the other, paying so much attention to one more than the other. And a lot of people came to the lady's aid. A lot of people were commenting about it, because it's like she just wants to come clean and say that, "I'm not going after you for money. There were times your families chased me. They chased me because they wanted to tell me that you want the child, you will come around, you will grow up." You know, he will grow up. By then he was a kid and was acting like a child. So his family was assuring her that Wizkid will grow up and would definitely take responsibilities. But then people came up and they were commenting under it. One person said, "I would just ignore the hell out of him and live my entire best life. And whenever he would want to see him, I would just say, 'Pick him up, nigga.' And, you know, average, I don't want to say that. By the way, stop sending him messages. He clearly doesn't give a something, something, something." Yeah, you guys will see that. So you get to bust up and just ignore him, leave the nigga alone, find you a new hubby and a new daddy to care for your son. That's all you need right now. Yes. And another says, "This woman caused everything from the beginning. Any reasonable person should know that she appeared as a desperate person. Wow. If he doesn't love you, there's nothing you will do that will make him to. It seems like you wanted to be more than a baby mama, which you are to him. To be honest, I know it's all because you love him, but things have limits. You're a queen and a worthy woman. You're priceless. You shouldn't try to force yourself on anyone." And someone is saying, "I read the story and I can say Shola is a very calm person and it's well with you and your son. May God continue to watch over him. Most of you insulting her doesn't know how it feels to have a deadbeat father." Yes, with a broken heart. "If you know how it feels to raise a child all by yourself, you won't insult her for calling him out. It's a phase and it would definitely pass." But then if you look through the post that she's making, you can see that all through it she's just saying that, "I am triumphing, I'm standing. Yes. Now let's move away from Nigeria and let's go to the international front. What is going on? You know, a lot of people have heard about Bill Cosby. You're talking about the father of America, not just the father of America, but the father of the whole world. Who hasn't watched Bill Cosby? Bill Cosby was just all over the place. He was the real deal, you know. He was the father that was telling the young boys to pull their pants out. But as a matter of fact, father, your pants were down too, as you're asking them to pull it out. What are we talking about? He's been, you know, he's been charged with aggravated assault by so many women. So in as much as we are seeing Bill Cosby, we're learning a lot from him, we like him and all that, Bill Cosby has just got something going on. He just couldn't keep his pants up. I'm sorry, you're a big daddy now. He's 81 years, but then as a matter of fact, he caused a lot of chaos. And he, I don't want to say destroyed the lives of those young ladies he took advantage of and all that. Yes, and Bill Cosby, what has he done? As a matter of fact, he tried to ask a judge. I mean, he tried to bribe the judge and he failed. You know, it's like it just bounced back to him. His team is made up of 15 attorneys. As a matter of fact, he's got just so much money. He thought he could just buy his way out, but unfortunately, you've done so much harm. you know, there's nothing that can be done about it. And they just says, no, you can do that. You can pay me off, you can buy it. This thing is just out in the world and everyone is pulling up, and all of a sudden you just want me to just say, you are not guilty, you're a free man, you can walk away. No, it's not gonna work, because yeah, you've been found guilty. And he's looking up to about 30 years in prison. Goodness, he's already 81. I don't know if he might live up to 130 years, we can't know. Yeah, but then it's very sad, and it looks like his wife is just steadfast with him. His wife is just saying, till death do us apart, I am going to stand with you through thick and thin. She's just not moving an inch, despite what the ladies were saying, they're testifying and all that. She said she's not moving an inch. She's even accusing the judge of being a fraud or something like that. So she wants people to look into the judge and all that. Woman, please, open. Come on, get up. Your husband has assaulted a lot of young ladies and all that. But well, we're just hoping that justice will be served and those young ladies will just, you know, feel okay and then move on with their lives. Well, that's all for entertainment news and on social media trends. We're accessible on www.vnationtv.com. Follow us on all our social media platforms and let's get interactive. And if, of course, you want a repost of this story and other entertainment story VNTV has to offer, subscribe to our YouTube channel. For those of you in Ghana who are working, until then, that I see you tomorrow, kindly enjoy your holiday weekend. My name is Tinia Modiasi.